Please rise. Peter came up to say and said to Jesus, "Lord, how often will my brother sin against me and I forgive him? As many as seven times?" Jesus said to him, "I say to you, not seven times, but 70 times seven. Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen." Please be seated. My dear brother, my dear sister in Christ Jesus, forgiving can be very, very difficult. I know that you know that. As a Christian, you also know, and I know this also, that it's very important, and it's even commanded by our Lord, that we forgive. You also know that we live in a sin-fallen world where forgiveness is mocked and it's almost always withheld. Therefore, this morning, we hear from our Lord and Savior, who teaches us the importance of forgiveness. It's so important that He even took the lead and was nailed to a cross and forgave sinful man first. The parable of the unforgiving servant, as you heard Logan read, is a teaching that is foundational for His disciples. The disciples then and the disciples today. If you think, dear one, that you must earn or that you merit or that you deserve His forgiveness, allow me to be blunt. You think wrong. Our Lord's forgiveness is never ever earned, never ever merited, never ever deserved, since you and I are sinners. And we break His law daily and much by what we do and by what we do not do. What we actually earn, merit, and deserve is eternal condemnation. Now this is important for us. This is important. The Greek word that Matthew uses and writes and is translated as forgive in English literally means to release, to let go of, to loose. When you and I forgive, what we are actually doing is releasing someone from the retribution and retaliation, our retribution, our retaliation, which may well be deserved, by the way, in accord with God's holy law, not our unholy law. Now this releasing can only be done. It can only be done by believers in Christ Jesus, who is their Lord and Savior. True releasing, true letting go, flows from that which you have been released from. True releasing flows from Jesus and His cross, God's forgiveness. Without the Spirit, without the cross, there can be no forgiveness. Because we have been forgiven, we can now release, let loose, forgive. Releasing, loosing, forgiving. Forgiving someone, anyone, can only be done by the Holy Spirit as He leads us to do this great work. It is an act of a regenerated disciple of Jesus. Yes, emotions will follow. Emotions will follow after you do release someone, and those emotions will probably follow kicking and screaming all the way. My dear brother, my dear sister, the distress that you will feel due to the experience of having to endure the anger, the hurt, the sin of another person lasts a long time, even after you have released them, forgiven them. What you have heard in the Holy Gospel this morning, from your Lord and Savior, by the way, is that your distress Your anger, your hurt, your sin is actually needless now because it's been paid for. Just as the children have been told that their sin has been paid for, paid in full. You may have released a person who committed a great sin against you. I know you've done this, been there, done that also. But your emotions can, and your emotions most often do, take a very, very long time to understand why you made this decision, why you forgave. You see, your emotions, they are a deep wound, and they remember these deep wounds, and these deep wounds take time to mend. Yes, you will certainly experience hostility, anxiety, or even doubt as to why you even considered releasing, loosing, forgiving anyone. Yet, dear one, I ask you to always remember this. Always, always remember this. You must never doubt the fact of God's unlimited releasing, loosing, forgiving of you, of all your sins, for the sake of His Son, the Christ. Oh, there is power in forgiveness. The world will tell you that, but God tells you that. There is power in forgiveness. Never ever doubt the releasing, the forgiving, the loosing. It is not useless. When you forgive, dear one, when you forgive, you are being a Christian. Your emotions will certainly cloud your heart and your mind. That's our human dilemma. The Spirit moves us to forgive, but our emotions, old Adam, doesn't want us to forgive. Yet we are reminded, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Dearly beloved, His holy word is full of assurance, that when God forgives you, you are completely set free. As far as the east is from the west, so far does He remove our transgressions from us. Oh, there is no doubt. There is no doubt, and you know this well. Your conscience, your family, your friends will remind you over and over again that you were a fool for forgiving that person. That's old Adam screaming at the top of his voice, "What a crazy thing you did!" And the world will remind you of this also. But dearest one, releasing, letting go of the retribution, letting go of the retaliation and forgiving is a blessing unto you. No longer will you bear that burden. The Lord will bless you also as you let go of the burden, as He announces to you, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have forgiven, and I forgive you also." Finally, we are called to forgive, to release one another. And we are to do this unconditionally and always, always, always. It's not about the numbers. It's not about multiplication, 70 times 7. What Jesus means is that we are to forgive always, just as we are forgiven always. To steadfastly to refuse to forgive someone, just as you heard in the parable. That's what an unjust and wicked servant does. And that unjust and wicked servant one day will be thrown into jail, and he or she will be tortured forever and ever. Dear one, that's not you. That is not you. Remember, Jesus tells us, "I do not say to you 7 times, but 70 times 7. Forgiveness is unlimited. Just as your Lord has forgiven you of all of your sins, and it is limitless, it is lasting, and it is forever. For in the blood of the Lamb, in the blood of the Lamb, your sins are washed away. Your sins are forgiven. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Thanks be to Jesus. Amen. Please rise. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus, now and forever. Amen.